Before you could even understand what was happening violently, could you possibly picture yourself being decompressed? The Byford Dolphin, a semi-submersible column stabilized drilling rig operated by Dolphin Drilling, was having deep sea maintenance performed by the four divers. This event, which occurred on November 5, 1983, in the Frigg gas field in the Norwegian sector of the North Sea, is recognized as the worst diving accident in history. It was a single heart-stopping moment that changed the course of six divers' lives. The divers Roy P. Lucas, Edwin Coward, Truls Hellevik, and Bjørn Gjeve Bergesen were tasked with maintenance deep beneath the rig. Assisting them were two brave dive tenders, William Crammond and Martin Saunders. Unlike most divers, these four maintenance divers were expected to work 18-hour days with only 3 hours of sleep. They could also spend up to 28 days in a small compartment of two highly pressurized living chambers stationed on the rig, complete with an escape pod, lifeboat, and a trunk that connected to a detachable deep-sea diving bell. This allowed them to do their work without having to constantly resurface, allowing them to work for far longer than would have been possible. In one of the rig's decompression chambers, the disaster happened during the decompression procedure. William Crammond earlier removed the clamp connecting chamber 1 to the diving bell before the chamber door could be sealed and decompressed. This may have been due to a miscommunicated order or audial hallucination brought on by the long workdays. Either way, this resulted in a severe explosive decompression as the chamber's internal pressure of 9 atm, 9 times the pressure of the Earth's atmosphere on the surface, rapidly equalized with the external pressure, which went from 9 to 1 in an instant. Therefore, the decompression's force resulted in severe injuries and everyone within the chamber died instantly as the fat in their bodies hardened and the nitrogen in their veins boiled and went back to its gaseous state. The entire body of one diver, Truls Hellevik, was sucked out of the interior chamber and shredded like fresh meat in a grinder. The tenders outside were also not spared, as the diving bell was launched like a cannonball and struck William Crammond in the head. The diver's injuries were particularly horrific because he was standing directly in front of the interior chamber door at the time of the accident, who later succumbed to his injuries and landing partially on Martin Saunders, who suffered two collapsed lungs as well as a broken neck and several shattered vertebrae, barely his life. He would be the only one to survive the accident in the Byfold Dolphin incident. Significant attention to the Norwegian government concerning the safety standards and practices in offshore drilling operations, particularly diving operations and decompression procedures. Notably, calls of corruption and cover-ups were ladder between the families of the victims and the press. Therefore, when it was found that the rig still had the majority of its original infrastructure and apparatus from the mid-1970s, which meant that it was deficient in important advancements that would have avoided this particular type of mishap in the first place, after the media probe increased safety precautions were demanded in the wake of the firestorm and numerous lawsuits. Stronger guidelines and improved instruction for those working on underwater drilling operations. This avoidable catastrophe ought to serve as a constant reminder of the risks involved with deep water diving. Long-term offshore drilling activities and saturation diving emphasized the significance of strict safety procedures, comprehensive training, and humane working conditions for the soldiers in the field. Please like and subscribe if you appreciate this video. I hope to see you in the next one.